Let me introduce you to Git as a continuous manager. You probably use some continuous tools like for your continuous integration or continuous deployment solutions. I want to show you how you can use Git and its powerful features to do the same thing and make a step back from the tools you already use. So basics, you need an SSH access to an end server for deployment or for staging, a Git bare repository on it, and a remote that points on this repository, this bare repository on your end server. This is simple. You just give the name you want, and then you Git push to this endpoint, and it's OK. So you have to define some hooks on your bare repository. With scripts, shell scripts, it's enough. I personally use most update and post-receive hooks that are triggered in different times in the Git workflow. So you can trigger some scripts when you push each branch or when you have finished to push all your branches to your repository. And then you just have to Git push deploy, or whatever name you want, to your end repository, and it's OK. And so scripts, I keep one script per task. I keep them in the dedicated folder, updated or post-receive D, as you wish. You do the trick as you want. So what use cases? Unit tests, you probably use continuous tools, continuous integration tools like Jenkins, Travis, GitLab CI, whatever you want. You can run your test scripts. It's as simple as just checkouting your branch you want to test in a temporary folder and run your make file, npm run test, whatever you want, whatever you need. Same thing for functional testing. Even if you rely on some online platform solution like BrowserStack or SourceLab with Selenium drivers if you do web application like I do. And then same thing, you can call these platforms directly from your shell scripts using curl to call their API. So it's simple and it's OK. You can do builds with a Docker container, for example. And it works very well. You can make delivery and packages directly on your end server and staging or end production server, because you probably rely on user space or SFTP or async or whatever to deliver your stuff. But pushing in production with Git is as simple as just checkouting your production branch in your production folder and restart your app, and everything runs. Just simple like this. Same thing for migrations. You just have to check out your production branch and call your migration script or roll back your migrations directly on your server, reload your apps, and it's OK. You can also do feature flipping. This one is one of my favorites, because if you rely on ini or YAML, if you like YAML configuration files, to store your ACL permissions, flags, etc., you just have to rely on them on your feature flags libraries. You push them on the server or in the microservice that does the feature flag, and your app is flagged, is swept in a snap. So it's OK. What's about reportings and alerts? You can do mail directly with Git. There is a Git multi-mail plugin which works very well. We can send messages to several channels. You can stream BSON or JSON that can be exposed data to various clients that you can use later. And most of all, you can store the output logs of your scripts and then pass them through an ELK library, an ELK stack, and then see your results and do what you want with the results of your build, stack, test, and whatever you want. So scripts are powerful. Git is powerful enough. Just use your imagination. Thanks. I'm Mads, and the slides are available at this URL. Thank you.